Hello, everybody. It's Brian Buffington in lovely Northeast Georgia, where it's October and still hot as all get out. I'll tell you what else is hot. People's shared folders in Google Drive. You know, most teachers are very organized people. And when they get into Google Drive and they notice that their shared folder is a hot mess, they just kind of lose it. I mean, I've been to a school. I've seen people lose it all over the land. And I want to help you clean up that mess. All right. Clean up that messy old Google Drive shared folder. Y'all ready? Let's do it. So let's learn a couple things. So in the shared with me folder, this is where people get scared. Like, Brian, I got so much junk in there. I can't believe I have all this junk. People keep sending me stuff and they're just kind of irritated by it. Well, I want you to just kind of take a breath and realize that this isn't really a big deal. It's not a big deal. Even though you think it's a big deal, like, Brian, this is making me look bad. All right, because it's all kind of crazy. It's crazy. There's just random things people are sharing with you. And you're like, well, I want to control that. I can't believe they're sharing that with me. Well, let me go ahead and tell you. Shared with me is just like an endless pit of things. And it'll keep growing, okay? You're always going to have stuff in here. So don't go there unless you really need to. Does that make sense? Don't go in there unless you really need to. So for those folks who really want to be organized, you have lots of spare time on your hands, you want to take things that are important. So in the shared with me, people share stuff with me all the time, and I leave it there most time. If it's something I really want to get to, maybe more than once, I might put it in my drive. And so I know what you're thinking, like, Brian, isn't it already in my drive? Well, it's kind of in your drive, but it's really in somebody else's drive. They're just sharing it with you. So I'll take a folder here, a file. So this right here is from some guy named Clay. And you can right-click this, and you get tons of options. Add to my drive. Well, that actually puts it in your drive, so then you can organize it in some kind of folder system. I know you love those folders, all right? Teachers, they love folders, I know. So if I go to my drive, I've actually already made a folder. I called it Organized Chaos because that's exactly what we're trying to do. We're trying to organize some chaos. I made a folder. If you've never made a folder before in Drive, it's new folder, all right? Bam, you're on it. And you go to share with me and you're like, Brian, I really want to organize this so it's not just in this messy place, this endless supply of files that I don't know what half of these things are. So you can click on it and you can right click and do add to drive, or there's, you know, tons of options. There's this up here that adds it to drive as well. But I'm going to right click, hit add to my drive, and then it goes, it's added to your drive. But, you know, we need to organize it because that's how we got in this mess anyways. And don't forget, I made a folder. It's called Organized Chaos. I come down here, find it, bam, move, and but it's still here. Brian, you said it would take it away because it's so messy. No, it's still here. It's still a reference to it. But let me give you some good news. We can actually get rid of it and watch what happens. And don't forget, he's the owner of the file. He's sharing it with me. It's in my drive now. Now, if I right click and say, you know what, I'm going to remove this wherever you are. It's down here. It's hard to see. Did it remove? Here, I'm going to do it again. I got this thing in a way. So sorry. You can't see. I'm recording. I'm using some fancy software. Actually, I can just hit the trash can. There we go. Come on, Brian, trash can. Okay, it's gone. Like, Brian, you just deleted that poor man's stuff. No, it's still his. He has the file. He's still sharing it with me. I just got it out of here because I felt good about it because I already put it in my drive. So let's go look. Remember, I put it in Organized Chaos? Boom, and already put one in there earlier because I was testing this out, just double checking, and there it is. So it's in there. It still says he's the owner. Go figure. But now it's in my drive. I can organize it in my folder structure however I want to do it, and life is good. Let me give you another example. Well, usually teachers, there's maybe 10 files that you have to get to throughout the year. I'm talking about constantly, maybe like once a week. Things that you have to get to weekly, like the same file over and over again, I got another tip for you. You can put them in a folder if you want. You can also click on it, right click, and go star. Look to the star. And when you add the star, watch happens. Watch what happens. It puts a little star beside it. But now, over here on the left, all my most important things that I have starred, not everything, because then it kind of loses meaning if you star 5,000 things. So you come over here, you go to starred, there it is. Don't you love it? Don't you like it? Are you getting excited? Is your heart beating fast? Teachers, I know who you are. This is gonna fix things for you. You're gonna sleep really good tonight. So go back to share with me. And there's that star one. You know what? I can also take off the star. I can say, you know what? I don't need that star. Remove star. It's not a big deal. Right click is an awesome thing. Chromebook people, don't forget a right click is a two-finger tap. Mac people, that's control click. And there you go. Clean up your shared folder if you want. Brian Buffington, I'm totally cool with my share folder having tons of stuff in it because it's not that big of a deal to me. But if I ever need to organize something, I just add it to my drive. What do you guys think? You guys ready to do this? One last tip. Promise. View. So right here you can see I'm in, this is called list view. I got the name of the file. I got the person who owns it, who's sharing it with me, and the date. A lot of people, a lot of teachers by default, they have this view right here. They have the thumbnail view. It's visually stimulating. I understand. You get to see the files. You get to see the people in the videos. I get it. But you know what? It's not really a good, efficient way for me to sort and organize because I don't know like when these files are made, who owns them. I don't even know the whole name. See right here, the names are cut off. I prefer the list view. And I call this Little House on the Prairie sleeping arrangements where everybody's really close together in the wintertime. So you click that, go back to list view. This is where it's at. You want to be list view. Just do it. Trust me. Train your thought to go that way because it just makes sense. It's not as pretty, but it makes sense. There you go. Organize, organize, organize. Sleep well tonight.